Bismillah. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah al-Aliyy al-Azim. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wa sallallahu ala sayyidina wa nabiyyina Abil Qasim al-Mustafa Muhammad. Wa alihi al-tayyibin al-tahirin. La siyama baqiyyatillahi fil aradin. Ajjalallahu ta'ala farajahu al-sharif. Midhi alana min a'wanihi wa ansarihi. اللهم اخرجني من ظلمات الوهم واكرمني بنور الفهم اللهم افتح علينا ابواب رحمتك وانشر علينا خزائن علومك برحمتك يا ارحم الراحمين Allamah Tabatab'i rahmatullah alayh in first volume of al-Mizan he has very useful informative discussion about shafa'ah about intercession. One of the best discussions about Shafa'ah that I have seen is here. He talks about different groups of verses of the Qur'an. Some verses of the Qur'an say Allah is the only one who has Shafa'ah. Some say no one can do shafa'ah. Some say there are people that Allah permits them to do shafa'ah. Some people who have not understood how to put these verses together, they thought Quran is denying shafa'ah. But Quran is denying independent shafa'ah for creatures. Allah is the one who has the authority for shafa'ah, but he may grant it to other people. We have similar discussion about ilmul ghayb. Some verses say no one knows ilmul ghayb except Allah. Some say that Allah may disclose it to some people that he's pleased with them. So after talking about these verses, then he has a discussion and he says we need to discuss few things. What is shafa'ah? We have to define shafa'ah. What we mean by shafa'ah? What is the nature of shafa'ah? What is the subject for which shafa'ah can happen? Who can benefit from shafa'ah? Who can does shafa'ah? And when shafa'ah takes place? And he tries to address all these things according to the Quran. And of course he considers riwayat as well. But this is mostly Quranic discussion. So we start with the first point. Volume 1, page 157. Ma hiya shafa'ah. What is shafa'ah? What is intercession? You are all familiar with shaf'a wa shaf'a wal watr. Shaf'a means pair. Yeah, watr means single. We have Salatul Shafa, is two rak'ahs before Salatul Watr. Allama says Shafa'a is something that is coming from society, social life, collaboration. Someone who is seeking shafa'ah initially is someone that has something to do in social life and he thinks that he has not enough power or he doesn't know how to do it. He's looking for someone to join him so that he would not be single. Shafi' is someone that joins you so that you are not alone. Sometimes it's a person, sometimes can be something. a shay. For example, someone gives you a letter and you take this letter with you. You are not alone. You have also a letter to help you. He says, كَأَنَّ الشَّفِيعُ يَنْضَمُّ إِلَى الْوَسِيلَةِ النَّاقِصَةِ الَّتِي مَعَ الْمُسْتَشْفِعُ فَيَسِيرُ بِهِ زَوْجًا بَعْدَمَا كَانَ فَرْدًا فَيَقْضَى عَلَى نَيْلِ مَا يُرِيدُ. So, the person who asks for shafa'a, for intercession, means that I don't have adequate wasila with me. I don't know, I don't have money, I'm not well known, etc. I ask you to give me something, maybe your word, maybe you come with me, maybe you give a letter, so that I'm not alone. And he says, we do this in our life. Sometimes for seeking benefit, sometimes for avoiding harm. Sometimes you are worried that if you go alone, they may trouble you. For example, there is a case in the court, you need someone to help you. Sometimes you want to do a business and you want someone to come and negotiate and, you know, help you. So it can be for jalbul manfa'a, means seeking benefit, or daf'ul madar, to avoid harm. But not for every benefit and harm. It has to be something special. For example, it's not that if you are thirsty and you want to drink water, you say, you know, to someone, to come with me, I want to drink water, or I want to buy a sandwich, or, you know, food, you know, or bread, you know. It's not for something very simple and basic, something which is important, and you are worried that either you may lose something beneficial or you may get harmed. In the relation with Mawla, with Master, for us, in, of course, relation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but even in dunya, when people, for example, are dealing with the governors and the kings and people who have power, and then if they have worry that maybe they will be found guilty and disobedient, and maybe, for example, punished, or may lose their position, their job, etc., they look for someone who is close to the king to intercede for them. Or if they want a job, if they want a piece of land or something, they find someone to intercede. So this comes also in the relation with those who have power and mastership. Then he says, the influence or the impact of Shafi', the one who intercedes, is not arbitrary. Shafi', you know, you cannot choose every person to do Shafa'a for you. If you want to go, for example, to sort out your tax, or, you know, if you want to go to a hospital, if you want to go, I don't know, to do business, to market, for everything you have to see what is the issue and who can do shafa'a. If you want to go to the king, you have to see who is close to the king and can do shafa'a for you. So it's not arbitrary that you just, you know, pick up someone and say, you know, do shafa'a for me. And when Shafi goes to the master, for example, if someone is afraid of being punished, What does Shafi do? These are important points for our future discussion. Shafi cannot go to the king and say, please close down all the prisons. Because our friend, you know, doesn't want to go to prison. So you cancel your prisons or, you know, your judiciary or, you know, cancel the law because this one doesn't want to be punished. If Shafi speaks like this, he cannot do Shafa. He should not damage the whole system. Shafi must use mercy and kindness of the king or who has authority without damaging his wisdom and his system. Okay? So this is very important. He says, الشفي لا يطلب من المولى مثلا أن يبتل مولوية نفسه وعبودية عبده. Doesn't say, please don't be Mola anymore and don't, for example, think this person is your servant anymore. No. It's like going to a king, you know, this person is not going to be your citizen anymore. Or you are not going to be king anymore. No. Or to say, please cancel your system, your laws, etc. No. He says, just with respect to this person, although you are right, please exempt him with your kindness. Because some people who have not understood Shafa'ah, we will mention later, they think that the role of Shafi is to cancel Sharia and, you know, system of Allah, and they say how this can happen. This is not the role of Shafi. And Shafi is not endorsing sins and, you know, mistakes. No, this person is very sorry, but is looking for, for an opportunity to be given some exemption. Sorry. My mobile storage is full. I hope your storage is not. So, لا نفوذ ولا تأثير للشفي في مولوية وعبودية. Shafi does not do anything about my record here. Shafi doesn't do anything about canceling the relation between master and servant. Or fi hukman wala fi jazaihu, doesn't question the law or the penalty for breaking the law. Rather, Shafi says, I have no problem with all these things. But I know you are a kind person. I know you are a person that, you know, is very, you know, respectful towards your servants. So I'm just seeking your forgiveness, your pardon for this person. Yatamassaku. Emma bisifatin fil mawla al-hakim tujibul af wassaf. Either appeals to some qualities of the master that lead to forgiveness, like su'dadihi wa karamihi wa sakha'ihi wa sharafati muhdi. He says, you are very honorable, you are from very, you know, good background, good family, forgiving, etc. You are a gentleman, etc. Or mentions qualities in this person that show he deserves mercy. He's an old, for example, person, he's an ill person, he has children, he didn't know, this is the first time he's doing this. So he cannot cancel the system and do something that questions the authority or wisdom of the Mawla, but can use some of his qualities or some of the qualities of this person that they lead to forgiveness. Or can say some of his own qualities that the king appreciates. You know, he says, for example, you know, I am the one that has been serving you, and you know, you trust me, and you know that how much I love you, etc. So, if you really ponder and reflect, you see that Shafi' is in no way in conflict with the master and his system, and is not asking for something unwise or something arbitrary. So, shafa'ah is one of the cases of causality, sababiyyah. What does it mean? It means that, so please listen to this very carefully. You know, imagine, what do you say about the power of dua or sadaqah? We say, sometimes before dua or before sadaqah, all the factors were complete for a problem to happen. But because of dua or sadaqah, you bring a new factor that changes overall balance, and therefore you can be saved from that problem. It doesn't mean that there was a mistake, that you stopped that mistake to happen. No. Overall balance before dua was that. After dua is this. Like for example, if you take medicine, you may be healed. If you don't take medicine, you may die. There's no mistake here. Yeah? Everything is wisely planned. Without shafa'ah, this person deserves punishment. And there's nothing wrong. There's no mistake in the judgment. Shafi doesn't point at mistakes and said, you know, this person didn't deserve, you know, this. No. Shafi is a new factor that can change the overall situation. Is sababiyyah. So, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created this world, and He uses asbab and allows these causes to work, and He has also given sababiyya to shafi'. He has created this element in his system that some people can do shafa'ah with his permission, with his blessings, people can do shafa'ah. Quran says, يَوْمَ إِذٍ لَا تَنْفَعُ الشَّفَاعَةِ إِلَّا مَنْ أَذِنَ لَهُ الرَّحْمَانِ وَرَضِيَ لَهُ قَوْلًا. Surah Taha, verse 109. وَلَا تَنْفَعُ الشَّفَاعَةُ عِنْدَهُ إِلَّا لِمَنْ أَذِنَ لَهُ. Surah Saba, verse 23. لَا تُغْنِي شَفَاعَتُهُمْ شَيْئًا إِلَّا مِنْ بَعْدَ أَنْ يَعْذَنَ اللَّهُ لِمَنْ يَشَى وَيَرْضَى. Surah Najm 26. وَلَا يَشْفَعُونَ إِلَّا لِمَنِ ارْتَضَى. Surah Anbiya 28. وَلَا يَمْلِكُ الَّذِينَ يَدْعُونَ مِن دُونِهِ الشَّفَاعَةِ إِلَّا مَنْ شَهِدَ بِالْحَقِّ وَهُمْ يَعْلَمُونَ. Surah Zukhruf, verse 86. So, Allah is clearly giving us this message that some of His servants, including angels and human beings, after His permission, they can do shafa'ah. Angels can do shafa'ah, and human beings also can do shafa'ah. And shafa'ah is hukuma, not tazad. This is difficult, so I explain. Conflict, what does it mean? Conflict means that it comes and fights with something. Is it in conflict with something in the system? Like, for example, someone is going to take this person to prison. Shafi goes and fights with this person and, you know, doesn't let him to go to prison. This is not shafa. It's not like conflict. Shafa'ah overrides. It's hakim, not tazad. It's not conflict, it's overriding. Means it comes and changes the situation. The equation changes after this. In the Quran, for example, we have such things. أُولَٰئِكَ يُبَدِّلُ اللَّهُ سَيِّئَاتِهِمْ حَسَنَاتِ. Allah can transform bad deeds into good deeds. So if His wisdom requires, He can transform bad sins and, you know, bad deeds into good ones. Or قَدِمْنَا إِلَىٰ مَا عَمِلُوا مِنْ عَمَلٍ فَجَعَلْنَاهُ حَبَاءً مَنْثُورًا. And sometimes someone has done some good things, but he does something that he damages his earlier good things. So it's the other way around. It can happen. So, if there is maslaha, and shafa is one of those, you know, things that can be considered as a maslaha in the system. The system is made in the way that allows for a greater maslaha to come and change the equation. So, if you look carefully, who is the real Shafi here? Suppose Rasulullah does shafa'ah for us. But who is the real Shafi here? Allah Himself. Because He has made this system and He has created Rasulullah and has given him love and, you know, respect so that he can intercede for us and he would accept. This is why Allah says, قُلْ لِلَّهِ الشَّفَاعَةُ جَمِيعًا مَا لَكُمْ مِنْ دُونِهِ مِنْ وَلِيٍّ وَلَا شَفِيٍّ لَيْسَ لَهُمْ مِنْ دُونِهِ وَلَا شَفِيٍّ. So, Allama is trying to say that don't be surprised why in some verses Allah says He's the only Shafi. Because first of all, He's the only independent Shafi. And secondly, He is the one who has made this system of shafa'ah and has made those who do shafa'ah kind and respects their shafa'ah. He gives them haqq al-shafa'ah, the right for shafa'ah. Then he starts after this discussion with some objections. Some people have said, if Allah doesn't punish a criminal on the Day of Judgment after he has threatened, yeah, there is wa'id. Wa'id means to threaten that there would be punishment. So for example, Allah said, if you don't give your alms, obligatory alms, there is punishment. If you do zulm, there is punishment, etc. They said, if this shafa is going to come and stop punishment of this person, we have a problem. Because was the punishment just or unjust? If it was just, why you are stopping it? If it was unjust, why it was in the first place decided? Yeah? So this is the objection. So they say, in kana adlan, kana aslu al-hukm al-mustatbi' lil-iqab zulm. If that initial one was zulm and this cancellation is just, so why Allah did that initial one? If initial one was just and this cancellation is unjust, why He allows this second one? This is the objection. What is the answer? The answer is both are just. Without shafa'ah, he deserved punishment. After shafa'ah, Allah compromises about his right and forgives that person. Forgiveness after shafa'ah does not contradict justice. Because it's like, for example, if you owe me something and I forgive, it's not zulm. Yeah? I demanded you my right, give me back. This is just. Then someone says, this person is needy, I forgive you. This is also just. It's not that I realized that in the first place I made mistake and you didn't owe me anything. He also brings a counterexample. He says, what do you say about those commands that Allah does as اختبار, امتحان, for trial? For example, Allah said to Ibrahim, ala nabina wa salam, to slaughter Ismail. And then he accepted redemption. He offered redemption. فَدَيْنَاهُ بِذِبْحٍ عَظِيمٍ. You cannot say the first one was wrong or the second one is wrong. No, the first one was right, the second was right. It was for test. The first one served a purpose, the second one also served a purpose. Each of them served different purposes. The second problem is that they say Allah has a sunnah, Allah has a consistent way of doing things. And He says, لَن تَجِدَ لِسُنَّةِ اللَّهِ تَبْدِيلًا لَن تَجِدَ لِسُنَّةِ اللَّهِ تَحْوِيلًا. He is very consistent. Shafa'ah causes problem with his consistency. It means that he has to change his decisions. The answer is that He is consistent, and this is part of his consistent system. Yeah, it's not that na'uzu billah is moody and may forgive someone and not forgive another person. You know, today says to the Shafi that I listen to you, tomorrow says I don't listen to you. No, he is consistent, but because his system is based on rahmah, on mercy and love and wisdom together, so he has set it up in the way that people can learn how to maximally benefit from his rahmah. Okay? So for example, you are a student. You go to a school which is very organized, everything organized, punctual. They are very consistent. They have love for the students, but they are also wise. They don't let students to take advantage of their kindness. So you study and you take your marks. They say this is your mark. But you had some activities. We give you also something for this. Or you, the teacher finds that you were very hardworking. The teacher can also give you some credit. But this is for every student in the same condition. There is no discrimination. Everyone can benefit from this. And people who are equals will be treated equally. People who are unequal will not be treated equally. This is part of his consistency. If you look at just one point, you say this person from paper took this much. Why he is given on his record, on his transcript, more? You say this is not consistent. But this is because you don't know all the rules and regulations. If you know all the rules and regulations, there is consistency here. Allama says, لا ريب في أن صراطه تعالى مستقيم وسنته واحدة. His path is straight and his sunnah or law is one. But this single sunnah is not based on one factor. There are many different things that he takes into account. Anything that can be relevant is taken into account. فوقوع الشفاعة وارتفاع العقاب لا يوجب اختلافا في السنة الجارية. Occurrence of shafa'a and removal of punishment because of his mercy, forgiveness, etc., because of shafa'a, is not causing inconsistency in his sunnah. Actually, his consistency, and he has taught us also so that we can benefit. You know, if Allah had this but had not mentioned to us, then we were not able to benefit. This is consistent because from the beginning he says these are the rules in our school, that we give you credit for activities, for charity work, if you are doing well in home, if your parents come and say you are a good child, if neighbors say you are good, you know, for example, neighbor, if students are happy, children, teacher is happy. So from the beginning, all are mentioned to us so that we can take benefit from them. So he has put all these things, and it's all out of his love. I mentioned with one point, which I had been thinking about it. Sorry. I was thinking some years ago about this issue, that maybe someone says, how it comes although we said all these things. But still someone may say, how it comes that Allah with His kindness and mercy in the end decides not to forgive. But then Rasulullah comes and says, you know, please forgive him. Is Rasulullah more kind than Allah, na'uzu billah? Or Rasulullah is not wise, na'uzu billah? Like someone who is not wise and, you know, says to the judge, you know, this is a murderer, but, you know, we should not punish any murderer. Rasulullah is wise, and Rasulullah is not more merciful than Allah. So how it works? There are two answers. One answer, which is very typical, is to say that what Rasulullah does is part of the mercy of Allah. Allah has kept His mercy in two levels. He gives up to certain level directly, up to a higher degree you have to go through other channels. And in this way He is establishing these figures as people that in dunya you try to make good relation with them and follow them so can they can do shafa for you. So it's not just helping with your forgiveness, helping you with your life in dunya. You have to follow this person. For example, if I tell you that as a principal of a school that your teacher has a right to give you extra credits. If I tell you this means that you can make a good relation with teacher, take his advice, take the homework, everything seriously, so that the teacher can help you. In this way, I am helping with your study. Okay? So Allah wants us to follow Rasulullah and love him so that we follow him more and resemble him, and therefore he has given right of shafa'ah to him. This is a typical answer. But another answer also came to my mind. Or maybe this is the mechanism, perhaps. To explain how Allah doesn't forgive in the first place and Rasulullah can say forgive him. Okay? In order to understand the question, consider like this. A mother normally is the last person to want her child to be punished or disciplined. Yeah? Because mother, as much as possible, is very unheard if, for example, the aunt or someone, for example, I don't know, a cousin says to mother of someone, don't punish him or her. Because mother has more love. Allah has more love. If Allah has looked into this file and said this person is not going to be forgiven, how Rasulullah can look at the same file and say, please forgive him? How can he even dare asking him this? Because he is the most merciful person. So this came to my mind that I think what happens is in this way, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has the whole file and records. He looks into this and sees that this person cannot be forgiven. But he shows part of it to the Prophet. The Prophet doesn't know everything that this person has done. So he says, please forgive him. Then Allah forgives him. Like, for example, if 40 people say to Allah, please forgive this person, Allah listens. Although he knows many things that these 40 people don't know, but in order to encourage us to live in such a way that at least we can keep 40 people pleased, he says, if you manage to have 40 people on your side, I forgive you. But if those 40 knew everything that this person has done, they might not have asked for forgiveness. So this is his mercy. Even he says, you know, in Salatul Mayyad, you say, Allahumma ashhad bi anna la na'lamu minhu illa khayra. You be witness that we don't know anything except good from this person. Maybe they know something, but Allah says, say we don't know anything. So it's so kind that if someone manages to live a life which on the surface in public is not sinful life. You know, if someone damages his own reputation in community and publicly makes sins, that's different. It's like declaring, you know, war. But if someone is trying to be living a pious life but has some mistakes that people don't know, even Allah may hide this from Rasulullah. Even may hide it from angels. In Dua-i Kumail, we say, بِرَحْمَتِكَ أَخْفَيْتَ وَبِفَضْلِكَ سَتَرْتَ. Yeah? So sometimes he hides even from Kiram and Katibin. So in this way, I could, you know, better analyze how shafa'ah works. So he shows part of the file to the Rasulullah, and Rasulullah says, please forgive this person, and then Allah says, okay, I forgive. May Allah inshallah enable us to benefit from shafa'ah of Rasulullah and Ahlul Bayt inshallah, and live such a way that we can also do shafa'ah for other people, inshallah. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen.